in any emergency, we realize that most of the victims, or the most vulnerable people, are children and women. And they face specific risks also. There is some risk of trafficking, of abuses, etc. And because they are children, they are also much more vulnerable, also from a psychological point of view. And well, physical and psychological point of view, so we need really to protect them more. Our priorities are basically the needs, because we are really a needs-based organization looking at what are the main needs on the ground. But we also, as I say, try to be more responsive to specific needs of vulnerability on the ground and to be sure that our intervention do not create further problems. I think it's a general change also in humanitarian assistance. We were, I think, very much focused at the beginning towards relief, survival, action in a way to go there and try to save lives. And I think then we realized that actually by doing this we could also have some negative impact, or we can expose some groups of population to new risks. We have to be careful in the way we are providing assistance, not to put some people more in danger. And I think that's some very simple things. If the children in a community are in charge of fetching water or wood, for example, we have to be careful where they go for this and to be sure that the water collection point will be at a safe place for them and that we won't have to travel long for that or to be exposed to those dangers.